Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I am thankful for the scars. Scars are the marks that are always left on us. Hallelujah. Be thankful for the scars. Hallelujah. Sometimes we look at our scars to remember us where God took us from, or to give us the knowledge and wisdom how to go about things. Because of the scars, it reminds us of some things. Hallelujah. I'm just playing this song and then I will read a scripture to encourage you and then I will leave. Hallelujah.
Water and deepest pain, I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Don't trade any experience that the Lord has taken you through for anything. My brokenness brought me to you.
These wounds are a story.
The wounds and whatever you've been through is a story that the Lord will use for His glory. Hallelujah. Be thankful for the scars. Hallelujah. I bless the Lord for another week. I bless the Lord for your life. And I bless the Lord for His faithfulness to His people. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. His word said, in all things we should give Him thanks. Hallelujah. Be thankful for the good. Be thankful for the experiences in your life, because in all, God is going to use it for His glory. I will read the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 1 going. Hallelujah. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains and have not charity, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though give my body to be burned and have not charity, it profited me nothing. Hallelujah. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunted not itself, is not puffed up, does not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth. Hallelujah. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Charity never faileth. But whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. That is the maturity in Christ Jesus, when you are being matured. The things that you used to do, or the things that used to move you, it doesn't move you anymore. Because you know that all things God is using to mature you, to groom you, to become more of Him than more of yourself. Hallelujah. I repeat there again. 11. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. Maturity in Christ Jesus has nothing to do with age. When I was a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass, darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know, even as I am known. And now abideth faith, hope, charity. These three, that is where I want to stand. And now abideth faith, hope, charity. Faith, hope, charity, these three. But the greatest of these is charity. My brothers and sisters, today I just came to encourage you that no matter how your Christian life is, if you can prophesy, you can speak in tongues, you can sing for angels to come down, if you do not have the love and the spirit of kindness, how to treat others, how to make others feel, you are just making noise. The apostle spoke a lot in 1 Corinthians 13, but when he came to the last verse, he says, now these three things abideth, which is faith, hope, and charity. But the greatest of it all is love. I don't know what you are facing in life. I don't know what the enemy is using against you in any form or shape, but let the love of God prevail. Some people may deliberately step on your toes. They may say some things to paint you. But there is something that I always say. If I have to go to someone to tell them about what I'm going through or what the Lord has allowed me to go through, then I have to God is good. Hallelujah. I just received a good message. God is good. Hallelujah. So when God allows you to go through it, the scars, even the scars of God, he looks at it and he gives mercy to us when we are supposed to be cut off. He showed it to the Father. Look at this. Your scars are for a purpose. Your scars is for a message. The scars you have on you, God is going to use it for his glory. Yes, they stepped on you. Deliberately, they misuse you. Maybe you were abused from your childhood. Whatever, anytime that you see that scar or you remember, you have to know that where you were before when you were going through that abuse, you are no more there. And do not allow anything to steal the love of God from your heart. It doesn't matter how others have treated you. When I read the book of 1 Corinthians, he mentioned three things: faith, charity, and then hope. But, oh God, God is good. God is good. Hallelujah. Your scars is a message. I just want you to be encouraged that let the love of God continue to reign in you. Don't let nothing steal that from you. Whatever you are going through or whatever the Lord has allowed you to go through, he's going to build his glory. Out of it will come his glory. He is going to do something good out of the scars. That is why I play this song to encourage you. I'll put the lyrics down. That is my message for you today. The scripture was something to let you be awakened of your Christian life. Don't let prophecy, don't let speaking in tongues, don't let you able to stand to let people know that I can give myself to be killed. Without love, you are just making noise. You are nothing before God. God is love, and that is what he wants us to be, in the name of Jesus. May you have a blessed week. May the Lord put a smile on your face. May whatever the enemy meant for evil turn for your good. The Lord is good in all things. He is good in bad seasons, in good seasons. He is good in times of when everything is working together for you. Because everything that the Lord is using in your life, the scars, the pain, the tears, is for his glory. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good all the time. God is good. God bless you. Have a blessed week. Pray for me as I pray for you, my dear friends. God bless you all.